الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. الحمد لله. See the season of blessing, alhamdulillah. You see it with your own eyes, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. And this is also to learn and to teach ourselves that the real blessing is what will stay with you for the next life. That's the real blessing. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you part of your deen, increase your deen, that's when it's a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. Amazing, was talking with a sister, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her paradise by coming today and tonight to declare her faith and to declare the testimony of faith. And she's been already Muslim. This is just to say it, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. So always you learn a new thing with a new experience, because everyone has his own journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every journey is special, and every journey to Allah is great. So one of the things that we learn, that she said when she first read the Quran, she got scared and she put it on the side. This is a lesson for all of us. She gets scared. I ask a question, what make her to get scared in the Quran? She said she was reading that the one who's speaking to Allah, he knows what is in your heart. So how can you read a book when someone knows already in your heart if you're not sincere enough to read it? And this is a reminder for us that the one who speaks in the book of Allah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who knows everything. So when you come to the book of Allah, come to learn and discover yourself. This is the second thing that she said, that the book, when I read it, is like speaking to me. And this is, inshallah, all of you, you taste that when you read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well, there's a reality that we need to be aware of it, and we need to remind ourselves of this reality. The reality that this life is a test. And there's another life, which is the real life. And in Ramadan, it's a training for us to remind ourselves how to include and involve the thinking and the planning according to the next life, not to this life. In the Surah Al-An'am that we are reading, we started today, in the first Makki Surah in the Quran, in the first Makki Surah. And the Meccan surah was being revealed in the Meccan period when the Prophet ﷺ was in Mecca. It always has this print of aqidah. It's this structure of more talking about the faith and cleansing the self and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah teaching the Prophet ﷺ all the element of the aqidah. It's a great, great surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sent it down, it was escorted by 70,000 of the angels. 70,000 angels escorting the surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this surah and in many other places in the Quran, وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي غَمَرَاتِ الْمَوْتِ. And if you see the transgressor into the agony of death, وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ, how can you see that? You cannot see it. But look, seeing through the Qur'an is more clear and true than to see with your own eyes. Because when you look with your own eyes, you might not see the right thing, because there's always something that might be wrong. As someone looking in a desert, thinking that it's water, but it's a mirage. But when you see by listening to Allah, your seeing is the seeing of the truth, is yaqeen. Therefore, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invites you to see, you have to see with your heart, with what Allah is telling you. وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي غَمَرَاتِ الْمَوْتِ. If you, all of you, reading Quran, are you seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inviting you, now He's open for you, is like a scene that you see with your own eyes, which is your heart, the yaqeen, the faith that you have. Because who's speaking Allah, you will see this transgressor, this ungrateful, this disbeliever in the time of the agony of death. And all of us are going to come to that moment. And that's this reality that we should always, not should, we must always remind ourselves of it. Because we said in Surah Al-Hajj, وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُتَوَفَّى وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرَدُّ إِلَىٰ أَرْضِ الْعُمْرِ. Some of you is going to die, and others they're going to live very, very old. But in the end, everyone is going to die. But when you die at that moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He drawing our attention to see that moment, specific moment, after 20 or 30, 40, 60, 100, 150, 1,000 years, that moment which is the most important. If someone is zalim, وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بَاسِطُوا أَيْدِيهِمْ, and the angel stretching out their hand, beating this person. Because basata in the Arabic, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, when one of Ibn Adam, he said, قَالَ مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطُ يَدِي إِلَيْهِ. I'm not going to stretch out my hand to beat you or to bother you or to harm you. So بَاسِطُ أَيْدِيهِمْ, why the angel that will be beating at the time of death someone who's disbeliever? Subhanallah, because the soul, so scared, will try to hold on the body. أخرجوا أنفسكم, get yourself out. Out. You cannot stay, that stage is the end. Out. أخرجوا أنفسكم. You cannot run from the punishment of Allah. اليوم تجزون عذاب الهون. You cannot run. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this scene very clear for us to remind ourselves. Because we have today the option and the choice that we're not going to be like these people. Insha'Allah. أَخْرِجُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. And we don't want to go into details of this scene, but just for us a reminder. It's a reminder to focus and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to finish our life with La ilaha illallah. Because the believer at that time, his soul is so happy that he's want to leave. So the angels, they will call the soul to come. It comes out. Why? Because the soul wants to meet Allah. But the disbeliever, the soul doesn't want to meet Allah. So it goes inside the body, hold inside. That's why بَاسِطُوا أَيْدِيهِمْ, they will be beaten to get it out with force. And once someone, subhanAllah, the next stage will be in a place that every one of us will be by himself. It is the grave. This is a reality. It's not a fiction. It's a reality. That's why in Ramadan is an opportunity for us to refresh all our element of Iman, to look with the eye of the Iman, to look to the reality as real, not as fiction, not as the shaitan. He tried to beautify it in a way that it becomes all illusion and fiction. This life is the life as Allah describing it, because He's the one who created it, and He's the one who decreed on us how we go to go stages to stage. When you go to be in the grave, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called, munkar wa nakir. When the person is put in his grave, munkar wa nakir. Qala malikani ghalidani shadidan. Aswadani azraqan. Lawnahuma kallayl. Sawtuhuma karrad. Aynuhuma kashuhub. Asnanuhuma karrimah. Should I give you the translation? Yes? They are big, harsh, dark, blue, and their sound, their voice is like the thunder, and their eyes is like the fire, and their teeth is like blades. They will ask everyone on Rabbih wa Nabiyyih wa Deenah, who is your Lord, who is your Prophet, who is your deen, what is your religion? And this is a reality, this is a fact. But, ikhwani, I want to give you this glad tidings. You, inshallah, you leave tonight happy, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who going to help you to answer the question. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, listening to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال يا رسول الله أنا كون على حالتنا هذه ألقاهما وأنا ثابت كما أنا هنا قال نعم قال فسأكفيكهما يا رسول الله. He said, يا رسول الله, are we going to be in the grave in the same state like I am here? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said yes. He said, so I will take care of them. Now Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his question is very profound. قال أكون على ما أنا عليه الآن ثابت. So it's like you have your mental capacity, your iman, you're ready to make everything in the sake of Allah. As in Ramadan, you have this strong iman, you are ready to pray, you are close to Allah. Are we going to be in this state? The Prophet said yes. قال فسأكفيكهما, we'll take care of. Look, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, قَالَ وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ, by the one who's holding my soul. لَقَدْ أَتَانِي Jibreel came to me and he told me that Umar, when Munkir wa Nakir, they come to him, they will tell them, Umar will talk to them. قَالَ يَقُولُ وَاللَّهُ رَبِّي فَمَنْ رَبُّكُمَا وَمُحَمَّدُ النَّبِيِّ فَمَنْ نَبِيُّكُمَا وَالْإِسْلَامُ دِينِي فَمَا دِينُكُمَا. He told them, Jibreel, you already told me that when Munkar wa Nakir, they come to you, you're going to ask them. You're going to tell them, Allah is my Lord, who is your Lord? Muhammad is my Prophet, who is your Prophet? Islam is my deen, what is your deen? You know what Munkar wa Nakir, they say? قَالَ عَجَبَا أَأُرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَمْ أُرْسَلْتَ إِلَيْنَا. We are amazed. Are you the one who are sent to us, or the one I'm saying, you are sent to us? This is the glad tidings for the one who has strong iman. Because Munkar wa Nakir, they are angels, they obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they love the one who already loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you hold on the rope of Allah and you gain the love of Allah, therefore you're going to be saved from here to the grave, to the land of resurrection, to the time when you meet Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all paradise and to give us the grant us al-firdaws al-a'la. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu al-ghafurur rahim. Tudu salati yarhamukumullah.